Hi students, very good morning to all. So we are seeing the third part of the second chapter, units and measurement. So in this unit, as a continuation of previous part, we are seeing some important practical units that we are using day to day life. So according to the length, while measuring the length, we considering various methods to measure the distance, longer distances and shorter distances. So for whole, the very important thing is the velocity of light. So based on this, so other distances, larger distances can be found. So first thing is the velocity of light c, whose value is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. So the unit meter per second is the SI unit of the physical quantity velocity. So for the light c equal to, so you think how much the longer, the 3 × 10⁸ meter. So same way we can mention it in kilometer. So 3 × 10⁵ kilometer we can say per second. So 10⁵ means lakh, 1 lakh. So 3 lakh kilometers per second. So the velocity of light is per second 3 lakh kilometers. So according to the SI units, we should tell in the meter per second. So 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. So this is very very important one physical quantity. Next, astronomical unit. So what do you mean by astronomical unit? We can say one AU. So it is the distance between the earth and the sun. So in the solar family, earth is revolving around the star sun. So the distance between the sun and the earth is called one astronomical unit, whose length is 1.496 × 10⁻¹ meter. So approximately we can write 1.5 × 10⁻¹ meter. Next, light year. So what do you mean by light year? So light year is the distance covered by the light per year. We know the velocity of light per second, its value is 3 × 10⁸ meter. So just you calculate for a minute, for a hour, and for a day, and for 365 days, which gives the 1 year. So you imagine and you can calculate the light traveled in 1 year. That can be calculated as the velocity of light into 365 days, and each day consists of 24 hours, and each hour consists of 3600 seconds. So totally this much of value gives the total distance traveled by the light per year. So the unit will be meter. So calculating and multiplying these values, we can finally obtain the 9.46 × 10⁵⁵ meter. So light can be traveled this much of distance per year. If light travels in the universe, so continuously if it travels, so it covers the this much of distance, 9.46 × 10⁵⁵ meter in a year, 1 year. So that is called light year. And one Fermi. So this is used for the to measure the least distances in atomic scale. So whose value, one Fermi equal to 1 F equal to 10⁻¹⁵ meter. So imagine 10⁻⁻ is how much is least value. So it is used for measuring the distances or size of the atoms, nucleus. So usually this scale is applicable to the nuclear values. So for protons, for electrons, for neutrons, the size of those things will be in the range of Fermi, 10⁻¹⁵ meter. Next, one angstrom, which is equal to 10⁻¹⁰ meter. So this is also the unit measured for the least values. 10⁻¹⁰ meter is the normally the wavelength of the waves, light waves, electromagnetic waves. So we can write the normally the for light waves, the wavelength will be lambda equal to in the range of 4000 angstrom to 7000 angstrom. So which means 10⁻¹⁰ meter. So the wavelength of the light waves in the order of 10⁻¹⁰ meter. And last one is the parsec. So it is also known as parallactic second. So it is also the distance, it's also the greater than the light year. So whose value is 3.08 × 10⁻⁶ meter. So here 9.46 × 10⁻¹⁵ meter only. So we can represent it in a unit light year also. So what do you mean by one parsec? So it is a distance at which the radius of the Earth orbit, that is called one astronomical unit. We know the distance between Earth and this is Earth and Sun is called astronomical unit. So parsec is called, it is the distance at which one astronomical unit subtended by the angle 1 second. So that distance is called parsec. So we can write 3.0 in 10 to the power 16 meter. So these are the measurement of the length. So length can be measured in the higher orders 10 to the power 15 meter and also in the lower order 10 to the power minus 15. So generally it covers the range from 10 to the power minus 15 meter to 10 to the power 26 meter. So this is applicable for atomic scale, for atoms, molecules and inside the fundamental particles also in the range of 10 to the power minus 15 meter, and the 10 to the power 26 meter represents the range of the universe, the length of the universe or size of the universe. So that is called, the estimated is 10 to the power 26 meter. So the length ranges from this value to this value. So it has totally, the range is around 10 to the power 41 meter. 10 to the power 41, because minus 15 to 26. Here mass is the very important property of the matter. All matter consists of the property mass. So mass will be is independent of pressure, location in the space and other physical quantities. So independent. So mass is always same in all areas. Mass can be measured in lower order to higher order. So for the atomic scale, we use the unit, unified atomic mass unit, which is called 1 AMU, atomic mass unit, or simply 1 U. So it is the value of, it is the mass of the mass of carbon 612, that is carbon isotope 6C12, the weight of 1 by 12th of the mass of the carbon 12 atom. So simply we can tell 1 by 12th part of the carbon atom. So whose value is 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kilogram. So it is called atomic mass unit. So every atomic scale particles are measured in terms of atomic mass unit 1 U or 1 AMU, whose value is this is. And a similar way we can represent the mass of the protons, neutrons, electrons in the atomic mass unit. But actual value of mass of the electron will be 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 31 kilogram. So this is in SI unit. So this is the practical unit. However, we should convert the normal practical unit should be in the SI units if more than one physical quantity is involved. So there is a confusion between the taking the SI units. So that's why we are taking the internationally accepted standard value, that is called SI unit. So according to mass, it varies from the range of 10 to the power minus 30 kg to 10 to the power 55 kg. So 10 to the power 30 kg is belongs to mass of the electron. So simply it applicable to the lower order, that is the atomic level, and the higher order will be 10 to the power 55 kg. So it represents the mass of the universe. So the estimated mass of the universe will be 10 to the power 55 kg. So in this range. So the total range of the mass from fundamental to universe is 10 to the power minus 30 to 10 to the power 55. So by calculating the range, it almost equal to 10 to the power 55 plus 30, that is 85, in the order of, that is we can say 10 to the power 41, the power 2, which gives 10 to the power 82. Also the length is the range of 10 to the power 41. Similar way we can trying to write this. And the third one is the time. We are using normally the time interval between the two events. So that is called time. So time is measured in atomic standard of time. So which is measured by the quantity periodic vibrations of cesium atom. How we tell the mass is measured in terms of the 1 by 12th of the mass of the carbon atom. The similar way we can represent the time in by means of periodic vibrations of the cesium atom. It is called the cesium atomic clocks. This time is measured by the clocks. So in all international laboratories, they are using cesium atomic clocks. So those will be very, very accurate one. So and the time range will be 10 to the power minus 24 second to 10 to the power 17 second. So 10 to the power minus 24, you imagine 1 second, the what is the time interval of 1 second we know. So 10 to the power 24 minus 24 means unimaginable, that is it belongs to the time represents the lifespan of the unstable nuclei. The half life period of the radioactive elements will be in the range of 10 to the power minus 24 second, and 10 to the power 17 second is age of the universe. As per the carbon radiating dating method, the universe whose age is calculated as 10 to the power 17 second. So the total range will be, it may be taken as 10 to the power minus 24 to 10 to the power 17, so which will give 10 to the power 41, 10 to the power 41. So it is also similar to the time, sorry, mass and length. So it is the beauty of coincidence between the length, mass, time. So all are in the order of 10 to the power 41. So in the case of mass, 10 to the power 41 power 2, in the case of length, 10 to the power 41. So it is the range between the atomic scale to the universal, up to the universe. So these three are very, very important: length, mass, time. Next we discuss about the parallax method. So what do you mean by parallax method? So this method is used to measure the long range of distance. This method is used simply, this method is used to find the distance between the planets and earth and sun and earth and any other planets, this method. So simply by means of parallax. So what do you mean by parallax? We know, if you hold a pencil in front of you, so behind some wall, so if you see by closing one eye and by using the left eye, say A, so note the position, and again you do it by seeing the pencil by using another eye, by closing left eye, you can view the by using right eye. So you can note the position of the pencil on the wall. So there is a difference between the two positions. So this is called parallax. So the difference between two positions simply which gives the distance between the two eyes. So that is called the parallax. By using the same method, similar way, we can also find the distance between the planets, two planets. So imagine if you take two positions A and B on the earth, so one of the planet, and you look at the another planet called S. Okay, so first you look at S from the position A, and the angle at which you look is noted, and second thing is you same time you can look at the same planet from the point B. So you can measure the distance between AB, and also you can measure the angle between ASB. So this distance, this is taken as B. So by using the theta, by using tan theta, the tan theta equal to, we know the formula, tan theta equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So opposite side is B, D, adjacent side is D. So if the distance between AB is very, very less, AB is very, very less compared to AS and BS. That is, B is very, very less compared to D. So we can write theta will be tan theta equal to theta. So we can write theta equal to B by D. That is D. So D equal to B by theta. So in this way we can measure the distance between the two planets. So you are in the planet Earth and you are looking at some planet like moon or any sun. So the distance between them can be calculated by D equal to B by theta. So in the same way we can also measure the diameter, angular diameter or angular size of the planet. If you consider a planet Earth and you are in the two positions A and B, the distance between them are is called diameter, diameter of the or angular diameter or angular size of the Earth. So look at the planet, any planet, and this will be the distance D and this will be alpha, the angle between the two positions. So the similar way, the parallax method, we can write for this alpha equal to d by d, that is small d by, so this is called capital D, distance capital D. So we should know about d only, we know the diameter of the taken planet. So d can be write alpha into d. So d can be measured. So this is the two positions. Usually we are standing in the two laboratories in two positions, and alpha we can measure by using the instruments, and d can be calculated by parallax method. For this formula we also find the distance. So if both are measured, and d can be easily calculated from the formula d equal to alpha d. So d gives the diameter of the earth or any other planet. So usually to find the earth, so this is called parallax method. So in the similar way we can also find the least distances in atomic scale also, some methods we have. So we will discuss on the next session. Thank you.